Vanguard Ranger Oswin the Swift of the Hallowed Knights Storm Host fears no evil and is relentless in his quest for the Storm Vaults. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint this gorgeous Citadel miniature up to battle-ready standard. We'll be using the classic painting method, using tips and techniques you can use across your entire Hallowed Knights army. Now, the first thing we've done to prepare our model for painting is to undercoat it lead belcher. We've actually used a spray here to make our life a bit quicker and easier, but you can, of course, use the paint out of a pot if you'd like to. Now, once the undercoat's dry, it's time to move on to the base coating stage. This is where we start blocking in the basic colours of our model. And the first base coat we're going to apply is McCrag Blue onto Oswin's shoulder pads. So, grab yourself your medium layer brush and let's get started. I'm going to take a little bit of paint out of the pot like so and apply it onto our palette like this. Now, the reason we're using a palette is so we can help thin the paint down with a touch of water from our water pot like this. Thinning your paint like this helps it flow onto the model a lot easier and will make painting a lot easier for you. Then, onto our miniature, we're now going to apply our base coats onto Oswin's shoulder pads like so. Now, as you're applying base coats, try and be as neat as you possibly can. Don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back later on and tidy them up. You also might find when you're applying base coats, you might need a couple of coats to get a really solid colour, but don't worry, that's perfectly normal. So there we go, the McCrag Blue has been applied to the shoulder pads, that's our first base coat done. It's time to move on to the rest of the base coats. So the next base coat we're going to apply is Corvus Black, which is going to go onto the leatherwork and the joints in between the armour. Then we'll use Rhinox Hide onto his loincloth and the wooden areas, including the big log on the base. We use Retributor Armour for all the gold on the model, then Morgas Bone for the cloak, Screamer Pink for the inside of the cloak, and then finally we'll use Korax White for the various white details on the miniature. So let's start off with Corvus Black, and for this again we're using our medium layer brush. Take a little bit of paint out of the pot like so, and onto the palette. Again we're going to thin it down just a touch, but not too much. And then onto the miniature, we're going to apply it onto the joints in between the armour panels, such as here, and also any leatherwork around the model, so the straps like his belt and the straps on the back of his helmet. The next base coat we're applying is Rhinox Hide, which is going onto the loincloth, the wood on the base, and the wood of the Boltstorm pistol itself. Now, when it comes to the Boltstorm pistol, it might be a bit confusing as to which bits want to be wood and which bits aren't, so take a good look at the artwork in the Storm Vault rulebook to help you out. Next up, we're applying Retributor Armour to the golden areas of the miniature. Again, we've slightly thinned this down to help it go onto the model a bit easier. And there's lots of gold on Oswin the Swift, including his shoulder pad rims, the handle of the sword, the helmet, and the Boltstorm pistol. So to save confusion, make sure you're checking out the Storm Vault rulebook to see exactly which parts of the model need to be gold. Next up, we're painting Morgas Bone onto the fur of the cloak. So that's all over the back of the cloak, and don't forget the small bits of fur at the front as well. Next up is one of my favourite paints. This is Screamer Pink, and we're using this on the inside of the cloak, the top knot, that's the hair coming out of the helmet, and the handles of the sword. Now, when you're painting the inside of the cloak here, it will be really, really easy to hit the silver armour on the legs. But don't worry if you do, just go over again with lead belcher paint out of a pot and correct your mistakes. The next base coat we're applying is Korax White, which we're applying to the various white markings all over the miniature. So you can check out these sigils on his leg here. Also, check out the sigils on the inside of the cloak and on the other side of the cloak as well. And also the lightning marks on his shoulder pad at the top here. With the white applied, that's the base coat on Oswin himself complete. It's now time to move on to the next stage, and that's to put the base coat down on the base of the miniature. He'll be using three different paints. First of all, Mechanicus Standard Grey all over the entire base, apart from, of course, the log, which we've already painted. Then we'll use Mournfang Brown on the soil, and finally, Deathbolt Forest to pick out the leaves. So grab ourselves our medium base brush, and let's get started. So here we're going to take a bit of the Mechanicus Standard Grey onto our palette like this. Again, we're going to be just adding a touch of water here, just to thin it down. Then onto the miniature, we're going to apply Mechanicus Standard Grey all over the entire base, apart from, of course, the wood, which we've already picked out. Don't worry here, if we're going over the soil and the leaves, we're going to be picking those out in just a moment. Next up, we're applying Mournfang Brown to the soil on the base. This time we're using a medium layer brush for a bit of extra control. And don't worry if you go over the leaves, because again, we're going to paint over those in just a moment's time. And the last base coat is Deathworld Forest, this time again being applied with a medium layer brush, going onto the leaves on the base. With the base coat applied all over the miniature, it's now time to move on to the next stage of painting. And that is, of course, the shading stage. This is where we use special thin down paints called shades to wash over the model and give it extra detail. We're going to use two shades in this video. First of all, non-oil will go all over the silver, blue, black, pink, and white areas. We'll also use agraste, earth shade, then, on the other areas of the miniature. So let's start off with non-oil, and for this we're going to be using our medium shade brush. So we're going to take a little bit of wash out of the pot like so, and apply it to the palette. We're not thinning this down, we're just making sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint. That's perfect. Then, onto the miniature, we're going to apply non-oil onto the silver, blue, black, pink, and white areas of the model. Now, as you're applying this wash all over, make sure you're moving the paint around to avoid the wash collecting and pooling in areas such as here. So you see that? You don't want that. We're going to just use the brush here and just move that paint around like so. Perfect. We're going to apply the non-oil all over the correct areas, and then we'll move on to the next stage. Next up, we're applying Agraste Earthshade to the gold, the brown, the fur on the back of the cloak, and the entire base. And with the washes dry and the base rim painted a Abaddon black, Oswin the Swift is ready to do battle in the Mortal Realms. And that's how you paint Oswin the Swift of the Hallowed Knights Stormhost up to battle ready standard using the classic painting method. A couple of things to remember here, make sure when you're using your base coats to be as neat as you possibly can. Don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back and correct them later on. Also, when you're applying your shades, make sure you're moving the paint around to avoid any areas of pooling on the model. Hope you found the video useful. Happy painting!